Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you, Gaurav sir, for such an insightful presentation. Namaskar once again to all the respected audience and dear friends. As I was informed to be a keynote speaker on this wonderful e-conference, and the topic was the challenges and the new domains. But I'll just start in continuation with what Gaurav ji was mentioning about the rising trends of cybercrime. Is that I think in this last 1.5 years, we have all seen various attacks, and especially we have seen a lot of data breaches, and we have seen ransomware being on the top, whether it's been the Colonial Pipeline of US or it has been the Haldiram at Noida for $7.5 lakh ransom. So we have all seen these data breaches. And what has been scary is that these data breaches are becoming a fertile ground for all our hackers. So whether it was the Domino's data breach or the Air India data breach or the Big Basket data breach, but we are all concerned about the online world. Recently, an incident took place in Palwal, where the Palwal police busted a gang where these hackers were stealing photocopies of land registries from the property department, using technology to create rubber stamps of thumbprint biometrics from the land registries, picking up your Aadhaar number from the land registries, and then swiping out lakhs of rupees from accounts using the AEPS, the Aadhaar Enabled Payment System. And in 3 days, around 50 lakh rupees from around hundreds of people accounts were stolen when this Palwal cybercrime cell came into action, and they busted the gang in third or fourth day. They found 2,000 copies of land registries being stolen. So today in this domain, the challenge is not only the breaches of online data which are happening, the offline data, the data which is here in piece of papers or your land registries or your photocopies, they also create a challenge and they create such opportunities. So just 2 days back, I received a similar call from Uttar Pradesh, and I connected my cyber cell team to the Palwal cyber cell team because it was a similar case. They received 15 complaints in a day where AEPS, again the Aadhaar Enabled Payment System, was exploited, and cloned thumbprints were created from the documents. So with this, I start and I see the challenges are immense now. Today, I have been working with the law enforcement very closely for last 10 years, and I've never been into hardcore forensics, but yes, I have been into hardcore investigation, digital footprinting, and helping the LEAs to gather information and trying to train them to make evidence admissible in the court of law, which is very important. And all these experts today whom you are going to listen are all great people in forensics, and they have done some immense work and immense contribution. So we need to understand that whenever any digital crime takes place, the first step comes is into the law enforcement. And when these people, they start collecting digital evidence, they need the first hand training to procure digital evidence admissible in the court of law, to understand the gaps of chain of custody, and also to understand that no digital evidence is being tampered. Because the challenge here is that why the court is unable to give punishment when they see that the digital evidence was not properly procured and not properly presented in the court of law. When I talk about the challenges, so we all are aware of it, and as Gaurav sir was also mentioning, the new domains, artificial intelligence, whether it is the VPNs or the proxy or the portable operating systems or the virtual machines. Nowadays, the criminals are getting so smart that they are committing crime. They are using virtual numbers, they are using VoIP technology, they are using proxies, they are using Tor, and they are using virtual operating, you can call portable operating systems, to avoid footprinting and to create anonymity, creating a challenge day by day, increasing the challenge for law enforcement. When we started investigations, 15 years back with these cyber cells, we used to find fake SIM cards. That was all. But then we were easily able to trace the culprits, though they were having fake KYCs and fake customer application forms on their SIM cards. But now, the more we are getting deep into these digital crimes, we are finding the footprints getting more complicated. IoTs, Alexa, smartwatches, cloud, and these artificial intelligence, where if it is involved in these crimes, like as Gauravji was also mentioning, that how easy it is to create a fake identity using artificial intelligence. And we have seen a complete rise of these kind of issues. So these are the new domains which are going to open for us. And as rightly said, research, awareness, learning and unlearning has to be the process. For you, all the young enthusiasts who are listening to this forum, apart from the people who are stalwarts and experts sitting here, for the young people who are having ambitions to come into this domain, this is where you need to understand that how we can focus on the root problems and develop technologies and tools and solutions for the upcoming problems. And that is where your contribution will pay. So what I feel is that, yes, forensics is getting challenging day by day investigation, but the ray of hope is that the Lockhart principle always plays. And I've always been a very positive person whenever I got into any case for investigation, that some or the other place you have a footprint which will help you to reach the right culprit. Also, I feel is that in this current situation, especially talking about children, where everything has gone online for them, for everybody, I would say in the last practical 1.5 years, everything has been online. So yes, there has been a tremendous increase in crime, but whether it's been social engineering or whether it's been frauds or bank frauds, every day there is a new modus operandi we come to see, whether it's just hacking into your UPI or getting remote access to your devices or installing fake applications. And fake applications with some malware. So it's getting very important day by day to understand the concept of cybersecurity and cyber safety in your personal life as well. Your personal devices, your clouds, your identities, your banks. Recently, we were investigating a case of SIM swapping, where the hacker, just because of data theft, could so easily manipulate the mind of that lady and ask her to send one SMS from her device to the customer care, that is 121. And he was able to activate an embedded SIM card that is called eSIM, the latest one, just by sending one SMS from the victim's phone to the 121 server. And her SIM got blocked and the eSIM, which is called the embedded SIM, got activated. He easily got into the iMobile application and he was easily able to take out 18 lakh rupees. He convinced the lady because he had some very, very personal information about that transaction. He was knowing the last three recharges. He was knowing the date of birth. He was knowing the mother's name and he was knowing the address. And he exactly quoted the amount of the last three recharges. So this is what I feel is the biggest threat right now, which we are not considering, is called data breaches. And whether it is online or offline, it is creating a huge fertile ground for cyber criminals. So at the end, the data has to be protected, whether it is online or offline. Privacy has to be the fundamental of cyber education today for all the young netizens. It is so easy to just get a cookie installed on your phone or to be a victim of some artificial intelligence bot, which is listening to your keywords and acting accordingly. So suppose I was just talking about getting a new PAN card issued, and suddenly I see in my emails, I have thousands of junk emails related to PAN card apply. So this is where we have to focus. And yes, there is a lot of work to be done in this domain, and we all are contributing to this. So I can see myself on the screen. Thank you for sharing my screen on my screen. So I didn't make any presentation. I just wanted to share my thoughts on this. So once again, I'll thank IASAR for inviting me, giving me the honor and the award. once again, thank you, and I wish all of you participants best of knowledge learning sessions. You have some wonderful experts coming up who'll be talking about more in deep into forensics and the challenges. So once again, thank you, Dr. Ranjit, for inviting me, and best luck, best of wishes to all of you. Thank you so much. Namaskar.